turn midnight. Brought to you by Ovaltine. Chocolate-flavored Ovaltine. Delicious, nutritious, instant Ovaltine. The fortified food drink that tops them all.
Now for a visit to the Secret Squadron Hall of Fame.
Gee, the Secret Squadron Hall of Fame.
Yes, Jack, and every one of these great athletes is a member of the Secret Squadron. For example, Crazy Legs Hirsch, one of football's all-time greats. And Florence Chadwick, world-famous English Channel swimmer. And here is Duke Snyder. His four home runs during the 1955 World Series led the Brooklyn Dodgers to their first world championship. Let's join Duke in the clubhouse. Duke, what do you do to keep yourself in top condition?
Well, Captain Midnight, I get plenty of sleep, exercise, and the right kind of foods. And I drink chocolate-flavored Ovaltine. Remember, I said Ovaltine, not one of those imitation milk flavorings, or the other kind with just a few vitamins.
That's right, Duke. Ovaltine's got what it takes. 27 vitamins, minerals, and other essential food elements that make Ovaltine such a rich source of nourishment.
And Ovaltine tastes good, too.
Right again, Duke. Boys and girls, drink your Ovaltine every day, just as Duke Snyder says. Get chocolate-flavored Ovaltine.
On a mountaintop high above a large city stands the headquarters of a man devoted to the cause of freedom and justice. A war hero who has never stopped fighting against his country's enemies. A private citizen who is dedicating his life to the struggle against evil men everywhere. Captain Midnight.
You nervous?
Oh, nervous? Who, me? I'm not nervous.
This time we're testing the effect of the bomb on personnel and equipment.
Personnel? That means people, doesn't it?
Don't worry. The bombardier and the drop plane could lay that bomb in your hip pocket.
That's what I was afraid of.
Observers will please put on your dark glasses.
Well, gentlemen, you've just witnessed our baby bomb.
And we want to thank you for the opportunity.
Boy, if that's your baby bomb, I'd sure like to see your papa bomb.
We will, Ikky. The general has invited us to come back and see the big one go off.
In 48 hours, weather conditions permitting, of course.
A message, sir.
Thank you. This is for you.
Thanks.
See you here for Big Shot.
Yes, sir. Thank you again.
Who's it from?
Tut.
Well, what's up?
He doesn't say. He wants us to be back at headquarters at once. Come on.
You hope Todd isn't in trouble.
Well, we'll soon find out. Calling Secret Squadron Headquarters. This is SQ-1 and the Silver Dart. Calling Secret Squadron Headquarters. Come in, SQ-3.
This is SQ-3. Go ahead, SQ-1.
What's up, Todd?
No details now. Somebody may be monitoring us. But it's about your friend, Dr. J.P. Hartley. I'll have your car ready to roll when you land. Over and out.
Dr. Hartley.
A medic?
Oh, he's a scientist. One of the great ones, Ikky.
What's wrong?
Well, obviously something big. Todd will tell us all about it when we land.
What's the rush?
I promised Miss Hartley we wouldn't waste a second.
I promised myself a hot shower.
What's the problem with Dr. Hartley, Tut?
Mrs. Hartley hasn't seen or heard from her husband in 3 days. She's worried.
3 days? Did she say any more?
No, she was too upset. She wants to talk to you.
Mrs. Hartley, I realize your husband often went away for long periods on confidential business. What makes you think this isn't one of those occasions?
Oh, because he always tells me so before he leaves and calls me as often as he can while he's away. But this time he left without saying a word.
Didn't you think that a little unusual at the time?
Well, not at first. You see, my husband is sort of absent-minded, always has some problem on his mind. He seemed preoccupied when he walked out with those government men. I thought he was seeing them to their car, but I haven't seen or heard from him since.
How did you know they were government men?
Oh, they said so.
Mrs. Hartley, do you mind if Tuck and Ikky look around while I make a phone call?
Oh, not at all. The phone's right there. Captain Midnight, I do hope you could...
I'll do my best.
Thank you.
Would you please let me have the Pentagon in Washington?
He always keeps his notes on his work spread out before him all the time.
May I look through them?
They're gone.
What's gone?
The notes. I typed them for him myself. I had them right here.
When did you last see them?
Night before my husband left. They were right here, I'm sure they were.
Mrs. Hartley, I'm sorry to have to tell you this, but those were not government men who came here for your husband.
Oh, no.
Washington has no record of any government men being sent here to see Dr. Hartley. Ikky, get some water.
Mrs. Hartley's doing fine. I just got her a nurse.
Nice work, Ikky.
What'd you find out from Dr. Hartley's worksheets?
Well, Ikky, he was evidently working on a process to reach perfect cold, the temperature of absolute zero.
Super deep freeze, eh?
No, a new super metal that can be produced only at a temperature never before achieved by man.
He calls his new metal plutonium, and if he succeeds in making it, he may have the answer to high-powered rocket engines, even space travel. Plutonium would line the rocket tubes. It could withstand the tremendous heat of supersonic speed, and it might even resist the heat of a nuclear blast.
Like the one we saw this morning, huh? Hey, Dr. Hartley's really got something.
Yeah, so have the people who've got Dr. Hartley.
Yeah. Any idea who they might be?
Enemy agents.
Yeah, but he walked right out with them. How absent-minded can a guy get?
He wasn't being absent-minded, Ikky. He was probably drugged.
One of our great scientists in the hands of enemy agents and us without even a clue.
Accept this bill for a propagidium.
Propagidium? Never heard of that. Must be one of the new drugs.
Well, then it shouldn't be too difficult to trace. You stay here and see what else you can get out of Dr. Hartley's notes. Ikky, you and I will make the rounds at the supply houses. Oh, pardon me.
Me too.
Who went into that store?
They bumped into me, the clumsy fool.
Then you bumped into Captain Midnight.
Captain Midnight?
Yes, that's our invoice. We're the only ones who carry propragidium.
Who want to buy it? I can't even say it.
Propragidium. Could you tell me what the properties are?
It's a substance that, combined with certain other chemicals, produces extreme cold.
May I see some of it?
Of course. We just have this 10-gram sample left. The man you bumped into as you came in took all we had left in the house.
He must be a big scientist.
No, but he works with one and was authorized by him to pick up the propragidium. We don't sell this without the signature of an established scientist. It's dangerous stuff.
Well, could you tell me the name of the scientist?
Of course. J.P. Hartley. He's ill right now, and that's why he sends his co-workers.
Thanks. Come on, Ikky. Well, they're gone. Let's go. What are you doing, Ted?
Well, I think I got enough from Dr. Hartley's notes to reconstruct part of his experiment. It might suggest a clue.
That's a good idea. Here, try this. It might help. 40 grams of propagidium.
40 grams? Where did you get that?
Never mind where I got it.
Use it.
Well, it certainly will help. Now we'll find out how cold coal really is.
And I'm going to find out how hot hot is in that shower. That is, if no one has any objections.
Objections? Just the opposite. Well, just about ready.
I'm with you.
All right. Now turn on the neutralizing field. Now we'll add the porphyrogidium. All right. Turn on the fuel generator. Now the hydrogen source. Turn off the fuel generator, quick.
What broke that? It was made of unbreakable glass.
Cold could have done it, but I doubt it.
All right, Mr. Aristotle Jones, what's the idea of turning down the lights and shutting off the hot water? You nearly froze me to death in that shower.
Tut didn't do it, Ikky.
Well, then you did it.
That's what did it.
Huh?
That little metal ball. Ball must weigh over 100 pounds.
100 pounds? That little bit of metal? Why, you kidding or something?
I don't believe it. 100 pounds. Why?
Must weigh a ton. Where'd it come from?
It was formed in the flask at absolute zero. That little ball is a particle of protonium, the super metal Dr. Hartley was looking for.
What's that got to do with freezing me to death in the shower?
While that little metal ball was being formed, it absorbed all the heat and light energy from all over the building. This means Dr. Hartley has succeeded.
Then his enemy agents must have the secret of this stuff, too.
General Tetley speaking. The weather has forced us to move up the test for Big Shot to tomorrow at 1400. We'll be looking for you.
Yes, sir. Thank you, General.
You're going to be able to make it? I mean, we're right in the middle of looking for Dr. Hartley.
Well, we'll be back by tomorrow afternoon. I can keep in touch with Tut in case of any new development. Warm up Silver Dart.
Roger.
Hey, Ikky.
Huh?
You going to put any clothes on?
What do you mean, am I going to...
Time out now to relive something that happened recently at headquarters.
Testing something, Tut?
Right. I'm going to clear up some confusion about the contents of these jars. All are called food drinks, and they're all mixed with milk. So you might think they'd all make the same kind of milk drink. But really, there are three entirely different kinds here. Now these are the better known milk flavorings. They taste all right, but they're just flavorings. And this second group contains only a few vitamins and minerals, but they're still primarily flavorings. But here, we have a real food supplement, Instant Ovaltine. You see, you've got to know exactly what you want in a food drink. If it's just flavoring, they're all okay. But if it's an honest-to-goodness food drink with 27 vitamins, minerals, and other important food elements that help fortify milk, then you want Instant Ovaltine, our official Secret Squadron drink.
Right. And that's why you should drink Instant Ovaltine every day. The drink that helps give you rocket power.
Why don't you start drinking Ovaltine today?
Soledad Mountains up ahead.
Looks hot as a furnace down there.
Well, it never drops much below 100. That must be the target area for the bomb in that general vicinity.
Boy, if it's that hot down there now, imagine the heat when Big Shot goes off.
Bring her around 280 degrees and drop to 2,000.
What do you see?
I don't believe it.
You don't believe what? What is it?
It's a field of ice.
Ice in that hot furnace?
Take a look for yourself.
Ice in the middle of a hot desert.
Look at that magnometer. There's a strong magnetic field down there.
Hey, and the compass is going crazy.
Wait a minute. Ice in the middle of the desert, a strong magnetic field. It all adds up.
Dr. Hartley.
Right. If we follow the source of the magnetic field, it should lead us to him. Ikky, set her down on that plateau over there.
Yeah, but that's where they're going to drop Big Shot.
No, not for another 2 hours.
Well, okay.
We better put on our parkas. It's liable to be colder than we think. Magnetic field is coming from inside that cave.
We see we were able to complete Dr. Hartley's experiments without the interference.
Perhaps I am too cautious, Orek. But knowing that Captain Midnight is looking for us makes me anxious to conclude our work as quickly as possible.
All we have to do is collect the finished notes. The plutonium sample is too heavy to carry. We leave Dr. Hartley and the machine here to the ice.
Dr. Hartley must be down that passage.
Well, let's hurry up and get him.
Now, that's much too dangerous for both of us to go in there. We may be trapped. You go on back to the plane. I'll keep in touch by pocket locator.
Roger.
Dr. Hartley. SQ1 calling SQ2. SQ1 calling SQ2. Come in, SQ2.
SQ2 to SQ1. Go ahead, SQ1.
I've found Dr. Hartley. I thought he was dead, but he's apparently in a state of suspended animation. His body temperature's down to freezing. Looks like they've been keeping him alive on drugs and plasma.
I'll come and help you carry him up.
No, you sit tight. There are stimulants here. I'm going to try to bring him around. Now, don't leave the plane unless I call you. Out.
My fears were not unfounded. It's Captain Midnight.
So it is. But how? How perfect. Now we can eliminate two very valuable members of a decadent society.
That's right.
There's enough reserve power in the field generators to keep them running for days.
Yes, by that time, this entire amount will be buried under tons of ice.
That's right, let's get out of here. We'll be frozen alive ourselves if we don't hurry.
Right, we can reach the helicopter in half an hour. Then we can radio our superior officers. Mission accomplished.
SQ2 calling SQ1. Come in, SQ1. SQ2 calling SQ1. Come in. Please come in, SQ1. Big Shot's due to go off in a few minutes.
SQ-1 to SQ-2. I'm sorry, Ikky, but somebody put the lights out.
You gotta get out of there. Big Shot's due to go off in a few minutes, and that cave's pointing right at the target area.
I've got to save Dr. Hartley.
Well, step on it, will you, number one, or we'll all be vaporized.
Dr. Hartley. Dr. Hartley, can you understand me?
No more, Zorak. No more. That's all I can tell you.
This is Captain Midnight. Can you hear me?
Captain Midnight.
We've got to get out of here. I'll help you.
Controls. They're on full force. Turn them off quickly.
They're stuck. They're frozen. I can't move them. Is there any other way out of here?
No.
Calling SQ-1. Calling SQ-1. Come in, SQ-1.
It's SQ-1. Over.
The drop plane's approaching target.
Try the Hermie band, Ikky. Try and stop them. We're frozen in here. We can't get out.
Calling Army PGX-1. SQ-2 calling PGX-1. Emergency. Emergency. SQ-2, over. SQ-2 to SQ-1. It's no use.
The GI band is jammed. I can't get through. Hang on. I'm coming in after you.
Get into the air and climb fast. Get as much altitude as you can before that bomb goes off.
I can't just leave you there.
You've got to. Now take off. That is an order. Out.
Will do. Out.
SQ-1 calling SQ-2. Are you still up there? Come in, SQ-2.
SQ-2 to SQ-1. Come in. What happened? Are you sure you're still alive?
We're okay.
Wow, what a break.
Settle down if you can find a cool spot. Get us out of here before the radioactive fallout begins.
I'll be right down. Have you out of there in a jiffy.
Can you make it, Dr. Hartley? I'll help you.
How can we ever thank you, Captain Midnight, for saving my husband's life?
Well, Dr. Hartley deserves credit for saving both our lives. You see, when his machine was turned up full blast, it created absolute zero, which absorbed the absolute heat created by the bomb.
Purely unintentional reaction.
And your equipment, Doctor, was it destroyed in the blast?
The room that held the machine was buried under tons of rock. Fortunately for us, the room in which we were being held had been reinforced.
What I can't understand is how Dr. Hartley could be frozen alive and still live to tell about it.
Well, that's not a new technique. Lowering the body temperature and sustaining life with drugs.
Those men brought me out of my coma only when they needed information. In my drug condition, I told them everything.
I don't think that information will do them much good. They were in the target area when the bomb went off. They couldn't have escaped it.
Well, it's been a busy couple of days, so if you'll excuse me, I think I'll take a hot shower. And will you please not give me that absolute zero stuff until after I'm through, Aristotle? Because I need a shower real bad.
For once, Ichabod, you and I are in complete agreement.
Boys and girls, because we've had so many requests for Secret Squadron emblems, we've arranged for you to have an official emblem for your very own, just like this one that I wear. And I want every one of my friends to wear one. You can never tell when it will be important. For instance, in case I need your help, I can recognize you on the street. Now, here's how to get your Secret Squadron emblem free. Go to your food store and get delicious chocolate-flavored Ovaltine. Here it is. Attached right to the top of the chocolate-flavored Ovaltine jar is your free official Secret Squadron emblem. You can wear it on your shirt front, or you can change it. Put it on your sleeve. Or your hat. Or your bike. Better still, get several emblems so you'll never be without one. So today, get delicious chocolate-flavored Ovaltine. Remember, at the top of each jar, you'll find an official emblem. There's no extra cost, not one penny. Be the first in your neighborhood to wear your Secret Squadron emblem. But hurry, the supply is limited. When these emblems are gone, there'll be no more. So get your Secret Squadron emblems with chocolate-flavored Ovaltine today.